morning. It was a crazy night last night. It first rained like you wouldn't believe till about 1 in the morning. Like, it was just coming down. And then it eased up, and it became really quiet. And I got up for a moment because I thought I saw a crazy light in the sky. So I got up, and I went over, and it was perfectly clear out. Not a cloud that I could see anywhere. And so went back to bed, and then the wind came, and it was so windy I had to come back and I had to tie my my rain fly down a totally different way. But what was crazy about the wind is about every 10 minutes it would change 180 degrees, and it would pull my rain fly one way and then push it another way, and it was really hard to keep it kind of in place. It was that windy. I must be in some little bizarre little vortex right here. And then there was the light flashing again. I'm like, what the heck? I got out and I took a look, and there was a thunderstorm at 2 in the morning on the ridge. So the wind kept on going, and then it died down, and then the rain came back. Where that clear sky went to, I have no idea. What a crazy night. Take a look at my tarp.
Check this out. I had to pile rocks on the corners of my tarp and on my tent pegs and tie onto some big logs just to keep this thing from flying away.
I'm packing up the bike as much as I can underneath my rain fly until I pack it away in the stuff sack and pop it on the bike and get rolling for a quick bite, grab a couple of supplies, and then get out of town for another rec site.
It's still pouring out, so we'll see how it goes.
Call me out, tiger. Call me out, don't you lie.
To say it's wet and mucky would be an understatement, but just forge ahead, get down into town for some breakfast. Kind of a miserable, ugly day. Hey, yeah. That's what bike packing's about. You take the bad with the good with the bad, and you have fun.
Whisper away my outdated doubts. Somebody do me the courage.
There's a little speck of sun over there, but it's over there. Still raining.
I'm not that old yet, I'm far too young. To not stand my ground. Well, my ways are mine and I don't wanna change. Not even for love. Now take back all the.
Port McNeill is home to the world's two largest burrows. This one was discovered in 1976 by McMillan Blodell Road Engineers, about 40 kilometers southwest of town at the base of a 350-year-old spruce tree. A burl is a growth caused by injury, virus, or fungus, and looks similar to a knot. This one measures 13.7 meters in circumference and weighs in at 20 metric tons. When it's not raining so hard, we'll go check out the other one that knocked this one off the throne in 2005.
Call me out with them blue green eyes. You know I'm a fighter, the good kind, not running with lies. And when the night is high, like you and I will be soon, then we won't have nothing on us.
Be
town, getting ready for breakfast this morning. Made my order. The waitress brought me my coffee. And a few minutes later, the power went out. Later we found out the power has gone out for the entire North Island, which is pretty big. Everything north of Wass was out. Luckily enough, the cook was able to scurry through orders just in time. The only victim of the power outage was I didn't get toast, I got bread. Had a good time. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to top up any of my power banks or recharge any batteries, but we'll just make do, see what the day brings. My sunshine is gone, the rain is back, and off we go. Sunshine, sprinkling of rain, a bit of sun, feels pretty nice.
It is raining, but all I can see is the summer we spent. The letter in my wallet, I'll keep it till we meet again. You should never doubt.
But a little sunshine goes a long way, both in the spirits and drying out stuff.
Friends tell me that I should move on and try and forget. But this is not another tragic love saga that dies in the end. The letter in my wallet, I'll keep it till we meet again. You should never doubt it's true, I am the forgotten you. You're the one on my mind. And I could spend the winter too, as long as I am there.
If you can't reach a branch, at least gravity always works.
What's different about tonight? I don't have to make any dinner. When I stopped in town, I had a really big meal. It was kind of lucky with the power outage, but still, I don't need to really eat anything. So, just gonna chill out and relax in the hammock. The weather's kind of holding off. We'll see what tomorrow brings. When I looked at the forecast in Port McNeil, it didn't look good. Bear with me. I'll show you around what I can. We'll go from there.